I'll go ahead and pour myself a drink. I really couldn't care less what you think. So save your goodbye kiss. I don't wanna know it's over. Cause ignorance is bliss. I can hardly see what's in front of me. Cause the vodka's running on empty. I can't stay sober.
Trump 2024, and that chick. Well, what am I looking at today? I'm looking at Ghost Citrus. Yeah, I know. Today is officially over my 30-day self-test, but I think I'm going to do the Shackley cleanse with Mrs. Nyhap and Christine. And I figured I would just continue to make poor decisions. I mean, good decisions. Hey, can I have a glass?
Oh.
If memory serves, this shit is just clear. But
I'll take a little shot of it too.
So far, I've liked everything from Ghost. It's the first energy drink that, well, actually, Celsius.
Where did this stuff come from?
Walmart.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Look at that. You poured just enough in my glass, and yours was perfectly full.
The sour patch stuff is awesome.
Good.
Warhead and...
I'll have to get that. Clink.
Definitely smells like citrus.
Citrus. For an energy drink, that's all right.
Okay. Yesterday, I received some hard salami, which is actually upstairs.
I could go for that.
I was going to bring it down, and I completely forgot about it. Then I was going to...
Where upstairs?
Slider.
I'm on it.
I practiced with a vacuum sealer on it already. So someone sent me two big chunks of literally leaking... Limburger cheese, and I've been informed that the really good stuff is supposed to be like that. This may be some of the most rank smelling cheese.
So hey Eric, actually, before I got rudely cut off by someone calling earlier.
It smells like a baby diaper. It's so nice and creamy. Now the stuff that I buy down here isn't it's actually pretty damn close to this.
So anyways, like I was saying, before I was so rudely interrupted, talking about your back, I started taking magnesium, glucosamine, and chondroitin supplements about 3 weeks ago. Don't do it, you're gonna shit everywhere. And it's gonna smell worse than normal fucking dog shit.
Can we possibly make dog shit smell more like dog shit than dog shit?
You're about to find out. Should have done that Saturday, right, or just before he went back to Sam.
Give him a big handful of
cheese and fucking sausage.
you know, I don't know why there is such a departure between the taste and the smell.
You know, Eric, I had a dog that once used to eat its own shit, right? Somebody said that if you sprinkle seasoned salt on their food before they eat it, it'll make their feces unpalatable.
Wait for it. Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to say, did you try it?
Did you try it?
I did. The dog shit tasted terrible. You guys miss me yet?
So what'd you do first? Kraken?
Kraken.
That would be Brad's. One of Brad's favorites. Oh yeah. Sharky. Cherokee, I doubt they're real, but really, who cares?
And really, one shot, I can't really taste it in there, so.
First in was Clyde, saying first. Then Clyde says, whiskey and revolution for all. And Phil doubles down with two more shots. And Rich says, cheers all. Cheers, Rich.
It tastes like a shoe.
What does?
The Kraken.
Like a shoe?
Yeah, or like what fucking seaweed fucking rum would taste like.
I think I've had it. It's hard to tell because all I have is Limburger on my fingertips.
Eric,
I wonder what the,
Can you ask? Ask. Ooh, ask. Ooh. Take it nice. Good boy.
I wonder what the life expectancy is on Limburger. I mean, how would you know when it went bad? Clyde says, with Trump indicted, time to get in the van. You know, Trump is probably just going, thank you. The one thing you really need to now watch out for is, does anybody in the Republican Party not support him? Because I think any Republican that does not support him is going to go by the way of the dodo bird. Even DeSantis climbed immediately onto the support. And as far as I'm concerned, more power to him. If he plays his cards right, he'll be the president in 2028. And I personally think there's two things that I would immediately address right now. I've heard some people, well, I didn't actually hear anyone say it. I read comments in some of the TikTok videos. Poco's going, as soon as our government said, we got to get rid of TikTok, that's when I was like, I absolutely have to reinstall it on my phone. Because I almost trust any government more than our own these days. Especially because they're all fraudulent. Even the Saudis.
Fuck, no. TikTok is a direct line to the Chinese government.
That's what,
to the Chinese Communist Party. Fuck that, you.
That's what our government says. But is it? I don't think it is. Isn't in Facebook?
Okay. Facebook is at least owned by an American, even if it is a fucking retarded-ass American. TikTok is owned by a Chinese company. Anything owned by a Chinese company is a direct line to the Chinese government. Nothing good can come of fucking TikTok. And besides that,
go on TikTok.
The shit that TikTok does dumbs down our fucking kids.
Well, I don't know. I don't really give a shit one way or the other about that.
I do.
That's a parent's responsibility. But have you seen what's on TikTok in comparison to Facebook? Everything I'm learning about all the fraud going on right now is all coming from TikTok people. And not a single one of them is Chinese. Facebook deletes and hides and censors. You know what's funny? You know when the thing pops up?
Two sides of the same coin, Eric.
You know what?
Two sides of the same coin.
You know when the thing pops up and it says, would you like, you want to share your memories on Facebook? You know what mine looks like all the time? Content unavailable. Content unavailable. Content unavailable. Everything I've shared in Facebook pops it up and says, would you like to share a memory from a year ago? Here's one from 3 years ago. Here's one from 5 years ago. Not fast enough.
He's gonna poop out fucking casing later. Probably when he gets back to Santa's, like, what the fuck do you feed my dog, Dad?
When it pops out and it says hard salami right on the side of his turd. No, the other day...
His poop's gonna have nutritional information printed on it.
The other day a thing popped up and said, would you like to share this memory? So I shared something that I had shared from like 7 years ago that still pertained to today. Actually, I think it was, here's my detailed list of all the guns I'm going to turn into the government. And it was just a white sheet of paper.
I got that notification.
With none of them
on
it.
I got the post.
I know. That's the only one. Everyone after that, it said, content no longer available. Content no longer available because Facebook has deleted all...
You know what's going to happen? They're going to try and take away guns and we're going to have a fucking ore tanker run aground in the middle of Lake Superior on a mountain of guns.
Oh,
I mean, the shit that's going on right now, fucking dipshit DA from fucking New York, won't go after violent criminals, but he'll go after Donald Trump. Fuck you, dude.
See, if this is allowed to progress, we have officially turned into, was it Venezuela, Africa?
We are truly a banana republic. And the only reason why Donald Trump can be blamed for it is because he was popular, won a vote, won the electoral college vote, because a popular vote doesn't matter, you fucking retards. Get it right. Because otherwise, shit-ass places like New York and California will steamroll the rest of the country with their shitty-ass ideas, like to get rid of gas stoves and fucking, you gotta have an electric car. Minnesota's trying that shit. I'm waiting for you know what? Walz and the Democrats in our state government.
You can go upstairs or you're gonna be bad.
Had two good ideas recently. Only two good ideas that I can see. One, free lunch for every fucking kid K through 12. End of story. I'll pay extra money for that shit. Even after Garrett's out of school, I would pay taxes for that shit. I'd pay a sales tax to make sure that happened. As long as that money just went to fucking feeding kids.
See, I really don't like kids.
I don't fucking care then.
Or dogs.
Or Limburger cheese.
Or Limburger cheese.
And then they also...
Or Scott.
There's also a law to prohibit corporate entities from owning single-family homes. Now, if you are local and you own those homes, fine, fuck you. But if you're a corporate entity buying them... One, I think once you have over so many homes as a corporate entity, the taxes should just start fucking ramping up on a bell curve. Two, if those homes are sitting empty, and you own more than so many and they're sitting empty, the fucking taxes ramp up like literally fucking way steeper than a bell curve, which I don't know how that's even possible. Because homes should not be fucking held as a fucking investment when people are trying to buy that shit and live in them.
Hey. No, I personally believe our government is lost forever if this is allowed to happen. This is something, and I'm not saying it because I have a feeling towards Trump. If it was the other way around and this bullshit was being pulled by the Republican Party, this is something that has never, ever taken place. And this is just more proof of the weaponization
of government,
one party against another. And if they can do this, that means that one party is going to try to hold power forever, and it, once again, like you said, it turns us back into a banana republic.
So what happens if it's Republicans are going to retake the White House, the Senate, and the House in 2024 with this stupid fuckery? Okay? What happens if they figure out Hunter Biden was fucking getting money from China for influence on behalf of China? We find shitheads like Jamal Bowman, Joe Biden, Hunter Biden are all taking foreign influence money on behalf of the Chinese government to try and fucking influence our country. Which, that's fucking treason more than anything Donald Trump ever did.
Don't we kind of already know everything you just said, not to mention let's throw in Hillary Clinton and the 33,000 emails that she deleted?
Yeah, that's fucking destruction of fucking evidence.
And yet we're going after Trump for something that, for the most part, read comments. Salty. Hello, naked, my old friend. I've come to be naked again. Then Scourge says, when the naked comes around. Multi-gunman says, head out on the highway naked, looking for the naked adventure, and whatever nakedness comes our way. Tardisius, puff the magic dragon, live naked by the sea.
What else?
Jolson says, needs more cowbell. Oh, I would have, but...
Yeah, you're gonna... I'm over
here. Matt's on the... Miles is on the phone.
Home?
Tardisius, sub-comment. Now more than ever.
So...
Well, maybe we'll get to it in a moment.
Is she in the kitchen?
Hey.
Okay.
Then Scourge, right.
So,
make a rum and coke.
Check your phone. Check your attendance. Okay. And then be prepared when I come home in about 45 minutes to an hour to do the schoolwork. We're going to sit down and make a priority of that. Did you get an extension? Absolutely, you just got to type. We can make that happen, all right? I got your back always. Just be prepared to work. We're not going to have the, I might play the game, because I can think and play the game at the same time. You got your computer? Can you get on it on my computer?
Didn't say anything about drinking it. You just said make it.
We're going to make it happen, all right? Otherwise, you just steam it. Right? What? All right, I'll see you when you're home.
Oh my God. Oh. Someone sent a brick. Ship to Captain Taint behaving. Scourge had me make that for you.
Is it this?
Yeah.
Okay.
He said make a rum and coke. He didn't say I had to drink it. He just said make it.
That's definitely rum.
And coke. Mexican, not just any coke. Mexican coke.
Uncut coke?
Uncut coke. Oh God.
So it still has foreskin? What the fuck? Let me see this shit. It's radio controlled car liquid.
Getting a little excited over soda.
No.
Well, 1814.
So it's either from 2018 or 2014. Either way. Hey, get out of there! You.
This time I'm going to get him with one of these. That's what I thought.
Come here, Marshall.
I was going to hang on to this next time Matt and Jim are here. And I'm trying to read the fucking comments.
Marshall! Come here, buddy.
Then there was the bring the air compressor down. Put 120 PSI behind that.
Yeah. So where do you say do a rum and coke?
Make a rum and coke. He didn't tell me.
I'm drinking a rum and coke, Jim Skirsch. Thank you very much.
Hector says, splarg again. Redneck says, Captain's got moves. Greetings, Captain. Last day of sobriety. Make the best of it. Hello. Hello, Nipple. Hello, Nipples, my lonely friends. Then he says, you might want to have your co-host sample that cheese first and see if they have ill effects. Finally, he says, well, not when Eric has him for the next 4 days. If he got sick and couldn't make it out of the house.
Actually, it said that, let's see here.
Redneck says if the cheese
goes... Ammonia smell.
Ammonia?
Instead of smelling like shit, it smells like old piss.
Hector says, too true to not knowing if it went bad. Dan says, by the way, 40 minutes. That's 10 minutes longer than Eric lasts in bed. C6, oh, and one more thing. Heard any good ice cream jokes lately?
Watch your body!
C6 is a miss. Mr. 27 says, intro, nice dancing. And Multi-Gunman says, that's not him. He's a pole dancer in a gay bar. 40 bucks is 40 bucks. Then he says, P.S., it's Guinness Drought Stout Night for me. Oh, you mean the darkest beer with no flavor? Actually, Jerry keeps telling me, next time I'm over in Ireland, I have to try it over there because it's nothing here like it is there. Spamani. If I had a gun that you had to dislocate your thumb to eject the mag, I would think that was a problem, laugh out loud. the way the gun was since it was brand new. At least the mags don't fall out of it. Zeus, you're gonna be so buzzed Friday, laugh out loud.
Speaking of which, Zeus, thank you very much for the video.
Yeah, that took him about 15 minutes from request.
Yeah, and there were some pretty disturbed looks when I showed that shit off. Some head shaking, some like, you stupid fuckers. And then people, though.
So as if I remember, I'll use it here at the beginning of this. Redneck, I use a shoulder rig for my Springfield XD, but it's not an EDC. It's my Investigate a Noise at Night gun. You don't need pants. It is a shirt to use a shoulder rig, but just your arms through the loops. Like you said, it had its place. Spy money. So you're going to riot because President Trump was indicted. No, I'm going to riot if they killed Daryl. You have to read between the lines. For paying hush money to a porn star that was blackmailing him. Sure, it is clear that it is abuse of power by New York. Maybe DeSantis should block extradition to the outlaw state. Well, he already said that he wasn't going to help. Help New York, that is.
You know what? Donald Trump knows, like some people said, he's made of legal lube. Any shit that's going to happen, they're going to try and fucking indict. They indicted him. You could be indicted for fucking shit by a grand jury. They feed shit to people and are like, I want to get the fuck out of here, so fuck it. Yeah, he's indicted. Let me the fuck out of this goddamn room. That's all grand juries are most of the time. I mean, unless you, like, seriously kill somebody. And they're like, fuck it, I want out of here. And besides that, they already showed that the one lady who was the... who was, like, the foreman of the whole fucking grand jury was nuttier than fucking... squirrel turd. Going on fucking doing interviews and shit. You didn't see that?
Mm-mm.
Fuck yeah. And she even looks, I wouldn't even stick my dick in her. I'm fucking famous for sticking my dick in crazy.
Mike says, cheers, man. Cheers, Mike. Then he says, Marshall is over to babysit Eric for 4 days. Pretty much. Fuck the government says, dirty job, but someone has to do it. Fuck the government. I wish everyone had the commitment and the fortitude that you've displayed today. You would not have the problem we do today. Sorry to say, there are two reasons for mental health systems
Eric, here.
And either unwilling or incapable of fixing.
How did you not fucking see this shit?
The out of control mental health crisis, and that is the one, doesn't fit the their agenda, and two, money. Always follow the money and you find the answer.
This stupid bitch. I mean... fucking ads.
Well, thank you for having me, first of all.
Did you personally want to hear from the former
president? I wanted to hear from the former president, but honestly, I kind of wanted to subpoena the former president because I got to swear everybody in. And so I thought it'd be really cool to get 60 seconds with President Trump. Of me looking at him and being like, do you solemnly swear? And me getting to swear him in, I kind of thought that would be an awesome moment. I can't. Well, I might be able to, according to instructions, but I don't want to.
Why do you want to speak out publicly?
Because this was a really cool experience. And
Senator Lindsey Graham.
Not a cool experience, you dumb bitch.
Fantastic.
It's a fucking, like, it's a duty to your
really
fucking
like
nation
you.
And don't
really
be a like fucking cunt.
Why was that person offered immunity?
I that I'm making a commitment. I don't.
You can't make this shit up, Eric.
Fuck the government says moonshine and revolution to all. Moonshine.
What the fuck is wrong with her face?
She's squinting.
No, I didn't fucking...
Because there's light bouncing off your balls.
My balls are probably still white right now. From lack of sun.
J-Dog's here at work. 18 hours ago.
You want the last bit of the hard salami?
I don't know.
Tom, I tend to vote libertarian if I'm being honest. Them and some Republicans. Mr. Merkmack 85, the three police officers that went right into that school, unlike in Texas, took the sick-minded trans she, he out, and heroes...
There is no she, that's a fucking he.
That are heroes that don't wear capes.
You know, just out of curiosity, Greg's like on, so, was this a male or female?
It was a male thinking it was a female, which we're going to start with fucking mental fucking illness right there. Well, and someone in that school probably told them at one time before they ever decided they were trans that they had a serious mental fucking problem and tried to correct that shit. And then this dickhead went off the fucking deep end and was like, ah! And then when he didn't get closure, he didn't get what he wanted, he fucking went in and shot people.
What court in?
You know what, and fucking if nothing else, go in and shoot the motherfucker that you had a problem with. If the school counselor says, hey, you got mental health issues, go shoot them. Don't shoot a fucking kid. Fuck you, you shoot kids, goddammit, that fucker should have been drugged into the street, fucking shot into fucking hamburger, hung from a light pole till their head fell off, and then publicly pissed on by anybody who wanted to for any fucking amount of time until they were washed down the drain by piss.
Okay, so here's another prime example of then I don't fucking know, because everything I've been able to find out, it was born a girl.
It was born a boy.
Because the mother said, I lost my daughter.
No. The mother was fucking, has mental health issues too. It was a fucking biological male that wanted to be a fucking female because it has mental issues.
So why, after spending a half an hour, could I not find that information? Because they hide it?
Because they hide it, because then they're transphobic.
How many people? Was this a long list?
They're transphobic. And they don't want to fucking... They don't want to fucking step on the trans agenda. Now you got a fucking college professor out there from a major college saying there's no difference between male and female. Female skeletons. One.
These people are retards.
One. Don't women have an extra fucking rib? Two. Aren't their hips wider to fucking facilitate the birth canal? Three. Jawlines are different. Lower jaws are different. It's all designed to fucking restructure society, Eric. Fucking
EMT's sub comment. They transitioned her to a was were. I agree, heroes.
That, where was that at? Nashville?
Mm-hmm. Now, if we can get school staff to be allowed to legally carry if they want to. Here in PA, the school zone is a no carry by definition, but there's also an exception in our Title 18 for sanctioned school shooting events, etc., and other lawful purposes in which misdemeanor charges have been fought and won by civilian rights attorneys in PA that is running for our Commonwealth Court with election. He definitely has my vote, so you can legally carry anywhere else. You can carry on property... on school property, if you want the chance of fighting a misdemeanor change in court, counter sue for your civil rights violation.
Okay, Eric, so you need to understand the fucking language these retards use. So, gender activists slam dead naming of Audrey Hill, which this is their fucking way of trying to fucking shut people down with the discussion. A dead name is so if you transition to a female and you said you're now Erica, Eric would be your dead name because it's dead to me! You people are stupid. You people are fucking retarded. Keep this shit to yourself and don't make other people fucking play into your mental health issues. End of story. Hell, if a veteran wants to go out and fucking act out in public because they've got PTSD, you need to check yourself too. It's a mental health issue, get treatment. You'll be better for it. Imagine how I'd be without mental health treatment every week, Eric.
Like I said yesterday, we never saw this shit up until recently. And I think some of the biggest problem is there's so many people that should know better, should say something, that have become fucking vaginas, and they won't. And like I said yesterday, I will never not speak my mind. Transgender? These people have fucking mental illness problems. And every single time we have some kind of a shooting, the first thing, what was it, that fucking absolute cunt from the, Pierre, whatever that fucking cunt's
Jean-Pierre
name.
Jean-Pierre fucking whatever cunt.
She said that the transgender society is mourning today, yet she didn't fucking say anything about the parents that lost children.
Or the fucking kids that are gone.
This fucking cunt should have been hung in a tree right then and there.
Just because she's fucking stupid. And the transgender... You know what? If I was transgender and some fucking transgender dude who wanted to be a woman went and shot up a school, I'd be like, guess what? Fuck that dude. Fuck him to death. Glad he's shot because they didn't have control of their mental health issues well enough. We don't need that kind of person in society, and we sure as shit don't need them identifying themselves and giving a bad name to people. It's the same as like veterans who do fucking stupid shit. And they, well, I'm a vet. I went out and shot up a school. Don't ever fucking say that around a real fucking veteran who fucking gives a shit and loved his country and served his country. Don't use that as your fucking crutch. Because you're going to find out that it ain't going to work for you with other fucking vets. Just like this should not work for other fucking transgender individuals. That they're mourning over a fucking transgender person getting shot because they shot up a school.
Hey.
Fuck you, they should have shot him more.
I'm happy.
They're now trans alive.
One less mentally ill
Eric,
person.
I'm going to say this right now. This video ain't making it very far. I give it 12 hours.
Multi-gunman. 686 running ahead out on the gun range. Looking for 357 Magnum Adventure and whatever. Revolver comes our way.
Mm-hmm. This video identifies as trans politically correct. Man, we fucked you guys now, didn't we?
Phil says two thumbs up and two shots. Then he says intro babe is two thumbs up. Then he says my right hand.
How much
did
you put in this thing, Eric? Huh? How much did you put in this thing?
That much.
Whatever's missing from that bottle.
Then he says, my right-handed bat, left-handed and right-handed. Oh, no, never mind. Cheap old gun guy, 30 days of sobriety. What color chip is that? Let me tell you, the color of my chip is...
Here, buddy. Here, buddy. We're going to get you.
Red, white, and blue. That chip will always be on my shoulder. One Sky, Eric doing the walk-in. I think our work here is done.
It's okay, buddy.
Marshall. Are you standing there trying not to move?
You should really tip the camera down for the shit, Eric. Take that off and he's off being nervous.
Still waiting for the.
You
next
react
step.
Better to that, I'd leave it on you, but you are not reacting well to that. I don't like that. There you go, buddy. All done.
Oh, I'm still waiting for the next step, and you got to hear Miles talking to Marshall. Because it recorded you.
Oh, fuck.
And then I hit send to John.
Is that John?
Tardisius.
Wow. Nice hair.
Tardisius. In 2003, Christopher Walken did the Weapon of Choice by Fatboy Slim, and he didn't get enough cowbell back then either.
I don't think Marshall likes the cowbell. He was actually looking like he was trying not to move there for a moment so it didn't make any noise.
If he'd just gone and ran off and fucking had fun with it, it would have been cool, but that was not cool.
Salty? Open up. It's the naked police and we have a warrant. You better be naked or we're going to you're going to jail. EMT, double dog dare you to G4, Gulf 4, another 30 days, not counting today's review if it ends up being an adult drink. And
G4 is a miss.
Sharky, back for part two. Then he says, what is the 700 Magnum round you're talking about?
You've never seen it? There is a 700 Magnum. Well, it's called the 700 Magnum. They'd made it after the 600 Magnum. Actually, the YouTube video is funny. Some of those, I'm not quite sure that the gun really exists or not, but...
Don't you mean 700 Remington long action in a 338 Lapua Magnum?
No, technically I don't. I mean a Remington 700 in a 7mm Magnum.
Sharky, Kimber cleaned up nicely from the jizz. Good job. Sharky SH, Ultra Babe, yeah, lovely redhead, no freckles. So either fake ginger or first ginger with a soul of her own on to the next one to catch up. Then he says, cheers all, Justin the AR on deck and a package. Here we go. Then he says, A Alpha 1.
A1 is a miss. But I do like the steak sauce. Had some today on my steak and eggs.
Sharky, the Nashville ass ran an AR and a Kel-Tec Sub 2000. AR was primary. Mental illness is the problem over there more than anything else. Been saying this for years. It's just sad how screwed up the health system over there compared to over here. Oh, also, we still have mental institutions and forced commitment. Just saying. Then he says SH, and nice. Okay.
That was that. I'll say that I'd
actually, if I drank energy drinks, I would buy that.
And here's the other truth, though. This is the worst of all of them I've had so far. I'm just saying, that's how much the good ones are. If this is the worst, and I would still get this one again. I think right now, I think it might have been the Sour Warhead Watermelon as was my favorite. But the blue raspberry warhead was really good, and the red berry warhead was also really good. They've all been really good. I'm just saying. The funny thing is this is probably the worst of them, or should I say, the least good one.
What's the weather supposed to be like this weekend?
It's supposed to snow tomorrow. Again.
You know, I ain't had a full week at work since I started there, Eric. But in 42 hours, I'm still making 1.5 times what I was 42 hours at the last job. And I don't have to fucking chase fuckers around. I have to chase equipment. I don't have to chase materials. I don't have to fucking load shit, unload shit, fucking drive all over the fucking place. God, it's fucking nice!
Daily, tomorrow we have a high of 35 and a low of 20 with a 0% chance of precip. And Sunday is 43 for a high, 31 for a low with a 25% chance. Oh, Tuesday is when we're supposed to get the next bout of snow, and it's a 96% chance on Friday that Tuesday will snow. But that shit can change by the frickin' minute sometimes.
You know what? I still haven't done a full... I think the closest I did was the first week I actually worked, and there was still a short day in there. And I'm getting a minimum of $500 a week put into my retirement account right now. It blows my fucking mind. I don't think I put that much in retirement in a month before.
In the club. Rich says, cheers, clubbers.
Cheers, Rich. I beat Eric to it.
And Hector says, cheers to Rich.
Cheers, Hector.
And then Hector says, in the club, wearing awesome napkin rings as earrings, edible undies, and a top hat. Smile Money says, the time is right for the club meeting. Cheers. And J-Dog says, Heart Club Mr. Holster. And I don't know what the subject matter of Locked and Loaded is tonight, but a lot of the politics going on. I'm sure it'll be discussed, but other than that, I tend to want to lean towards something less, and I still don't know if I'm going to have a guest or not this weekend. Going.
What's wrong with me?
Personal favorite.
Well, me.
Because I know you're here, the other one doesn't know how those work.
And you know what really sucks? I can't even go to breakfast tomorrow because John, I gotta work. You guys can drive by and honk really loud at fucking like 9, 10 in the morning. Laugh at me because I'm working on a Saturday.
Well, I don't see him by now, which means I probably won't see him at all, but we'll have to see, so.